shuffle motors in the low countries. And here you see the front loader removed from the compact tractor. As I mentioned in the video where I showed you this front loader together with the front hitch, that I don't like that those tubes, those hydraulic tubes, are not protected by any cover. So what I really want is to protect it by having a strong cover in front of it, that when I move it up and down, I will not hit those tubes. So what I will first do, I will take the measurement of what the size is. So here you see the dimension that I can use. So we'll take 56 centimeters as the length of the cover of the hydraulic tubes. So I didn't have the right U-shaped beam to make the protection cover. So I ordered this one, is 3 meters long. So I will take off 56 centimeters, and the rest I can use for making some other stuff. Now let's fit. Don't want the cover to be directly onto the tube. So this is a good position. So now we have the beam ready. It's quite a strong beam. It's 4 millimeters thick, 100 millimeters high. Flange length is 15 millimeters. So it's quite a strong beam. It will surely protect the hydraulic lines for the front hitch when it's completely up and I'm going down with the front loader. When it hits, it will not hit the hydraulic line, but it will hit on the cover. So then nothing is getting damaged. But also when a rock is falling down from the bucket, or I don't know, I'd like to have it protected. So what I will now do is I will degrease it using some washing machine, and then I will make it, I will paint it. What I did is I went to the local hardware store and I bought this paint. It's a primer and a color in one one go, so that's quite good paint. And it's the new orange Kubota RAL 2008. I haven't tried it yet. I'm very curious how it will fit to the Kubota, to the real color. I hope it fits well, but I don't know. We'll see. I covered my working bench in plastic foil so it won't get stained by the paint. Right sanding. Degreasing. So the original Kubota color is quite different from the paint that I put on. There's not a very good color match. So RAL 2008 is not a very good match with the original Kubota new orange. So I also have a spray paint with Kubota new orange. Let's see if that fits better with the original color of Kubota. So here's the beam, it's 4 millimeters thick, in the right color, ready to mount onto the front loader. So these clamps will remain and the protection cover will put on top of it. The only thing I need to do is to take out this bolt in order to mount the protection cover. So let's do that. So because the cover plate is now added, the total thickness that the bolt needs to cross is 4 millimeters longer. So I will use a longer bolt to have enough thread to have enough force to clamp the construction right. Now because on the right side the hydraulic lines are closest to each other, I will first start on the right because I think it will be easier to mount it there. For some reason the bolts don't want to go all the way through, so it might be that the thread is not running through to the end. So let's check on that. Yep, that's the case. So apparently the thread is not going through all the way, and because the bolts are now just a little bit longer, at the end the thread is gone and they don't want to go further. So the thing I need to do now is to elongate the thread a little bit using a thread tap, and I will do that in order to have the bolt go all the way through. Put some cutting oil in it, it helps the process a little bit, improves the cutting, and let's do it. So it lines a little bit in the way, but it will be there. We'll get there. There it comes. Bring the chips by moving it back a little bit now and then. Yes, I'm through. Time to put it back on again. So here you can see now the hydraulic line cover plate mounted onto the front loader. It's a very strong protection cover. As you can see, the front hitch is now not in upper position, but when it will be for some reason, then it will never hit the hydraulic lines now, but first the cover. And also, for example, when there's some stones or something like that falling from the bucket, when it's moved upwards, also then it will protect the hydraulic lines. So I think it's good to have this cover plate on.